IVM.
Hello one, hello all. Welcome to the Diary of the Traveling Professor. And I'm Siddharth Deshmukh, your friendly neighborhood traveling professor himself. I was just scratching my head and trying to understand how am I going to look at one more student presentation. Yeah, it's that time of the year when, you know, every teacher has to look at assignments and look at presentations and look at group presentations. And listen, some presentations are amazing, mind you, but most of the presentations, to be honest, well, the less said, the better. Today's diary entry is an examination on why this happens. Why are student presentations the way they are? And what is the potential solution for something like this? And why do I think it's a serious thing? To be honest, I mean, come on, it's a student presentation after all. Or that's what you might say. Well, let's just begin with this word called FAF. I think this word existed, I think, before Micans made it really popular. Yeah, Mica, one of the places that I really regularly teach. And faffing is this whole art of selling bullshit, you know, talking vaporware and making sure that you win hearts and minds and marks for the presentation without you saying anything of substance. That's called faffing. And a lot of Micans actually wear it as a badge of pride. I'm a Mican, so I'm taking the onus for it too. I think faff is a word like jugaad. You know, jugaad is a double-edged sword because jugaad can mean, you know, being innovative and being maybe cutting some corners or maybe doing some unethical things. It really depends upon your mindset. And faffing might mean the ability to set up a story, really sell a story, or even just talk without substance. So I'm going to talk a little bit about both. I think the ability to, let's say, sell a story, let's not call it faffing for a bit, to sell a story is an amazing ability to have. And every person who is making a presentation should have the ability to create a narrative. And I've talked about this before, but no point not repeating it again. I think making a presentation is not opening up your PowerPoint first, but maybe just looking at a Word document and writing out the story, identifying the keywords in that story, maybe just identifying the keywords and then connecting that narrative in your mind and kind of saying it aloud so that you can actually hear it as a story. I mean, Dave Chappelle, right? Dave Chappelle, that stand-up comedian par excellence, is one of the most amazing storytellers that you can ever find. And he's so good because, to be honest, none of his jokes are too funny, but even his silences are meaningful. And I think that whenever we are making a presentation, what we end up not understanding is the narrative of the thing, is the story of the thing, and the way in which you can powerfully use silence as well. But let's come back to why student presentations are the way they are. I think they are there like that for a few reasons. One is genuinely students have a lot to do. Too many presentations, too little time, so shallow research. And so therefore the requirement to faff. So that's one. The second is maybe student laziness. Student laziness means that they don't want to put in that effort, the same kind of effort that they might want to put in into a competition or a, you know, case study competition or maybe even their interviews or something like that. So there's a little bit of that. And some of that is kind of natural, especially with the amount of work that you have to do. The third is potentially more dangerous. It's called group participation, and that's something that is encouraged by the academics, because group participation means that every person has to speak. And some professors insist on it, saying that, okay, I need to know whether this person has worked and whether, you know, has mastery on the subject or not. And this leads to actually a very lousy presentation itself, because the narrative goes missing. And now, you know, Priyam will speak, and now, you know, Janak will speak, and so on and so forth happens and just destroys the hell out of that presentation. Another reason could be that people actually don't know how to make a presentation that is of value. Most of the times, the focus is on impact rather than of value. If I look at the workplace and if I look at presentations, I actually see remnants of faff. And especially maybe in the media industry or the advertising industry or any other place, I see a lot of these student faffers taking on these bad habits that they may have picked up in the course of their MBA and actually utilize it. Sometimes to bad effect, sometimes, you know, it doesn't work and they don't know why it's not working. Sometimes it works, but in a temporary fashion. But I've seen enough presentations in the real world to know that, oh, okay, so this guy must have been a faffer in college, and I'm sure of it. Okay, so I just feel that it is very important for maybe even academics to lay down the rule towards making a great presentation, no matter what the subject matter is. And I believe that this is a learned skill, and this is something that can help each and every student become a better presenter, no matter whether you're an introvert or an extrovert or the rest of it, to anybody. And I guess, you know, face it, in today's world, everybody's got to sell, and you need to have the ability to sell your story. You need to have the ability to create meaning. And I feel that unless and until you have the ability to ditch the faff and actually get to the value, you're always going to end up being on the wrong side of the train. People might like you, dear students of mine, people might like you, even in your job, for a year maybe, or maybe even lesser than that in today's times. But what will end up is that you will be known as a ye to sala bol bachchan hai. This guy just talks and doesn't know what he's talking about a lot of times. And that is not a good reputation to have. So if I'm in a situation wherein I have to tell my students, I would like to make sure that they contribute something of value. I mean, I've seen presentations which change the course of an organization, presentations that change the way in which people look at a certain department or look at a certain entity. And I've seen people winning pitches because of fantastic presentations, and none of them are based on bullshit. None of them are based on faff. All of them are based on value because of an exquisite insight that you may have got or an exquisite theme that you may have looked at. And to be honest, I don't think anybody is above blame over here. See some of the TED Talks that are going on, not too happy with them. Some are amazingly brilliant because they're authentic. But some of them are just, you know, making that faffy presentation last a little way too longer than what it should have. It should have been ditched when you were a student in college. I don't know what you think, guys, but I'd like to know what your opinion on faff is. And just write to me or talk to me, or, you know, I'm on the Insta and I'm on the LinkedIn as the Traveling Professor. I also do Traveling Professor Investigates. I think the next one of those is coming up soon, so do watch out for that. And if you love podcasts like these, just go to IVM and check out all their shows, dude. Check out all their shows. Until next time.
I hope you enjoyed that show. If you aren't following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcasts on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We'd like to thank the sponsors on our network this week, Seat Tires. So we had a fantastic week. Tune into This Round Is On Me, where Gauri Devidayal has a chat with Divya Ravichandran on the issues of waste management in India and how recycling, composting, and using eco-friendly alternatives can help. On Filter Coffee Podcast, Karthik speaks with Lux Narayan about his book Name, Place, Animal, Thing, an inspiring non-fiction fable about hope, positivity, and living your best life. On All Things Policy, Anirudh Kanisetty talks to Prateek Wakre and Rohan Sheth about Australia's conflict with Facebook and Google and what this means for big tech companies and the news ecosystem. On the Simplified Podcast, Naren and Tony talk about greenwashing, which is businesses unfairly marketing themselves as eco-friendly just to ride the sustainability wave. You should also check out the Cyrus Says episode with Varun Deshpande of the Good Food Institute, where they talk about plant-based alternatives. Varun does a great show with us called Feeding 10 Billion. Do check out this episode of Cyrus Says. They have a really interesting conversation. On the Millennial Athlete, Tanvi and Shlok speak to the badminton doubles player Sattvik Sairaj about his successful stints at some of the recently concluded games. And with that, I hope to see you again next week.
Namaskar, dear friends. My name is Ashish Vidyarthi. Life, as you know, is a journey. And you and I, travelers, how can we celebrate this travel? I have a podcast for you, Begin the Journey. I share stories and moments from my life. Do tune in every Monday and Thursday to listen to my podcast on the IVM Podcast website, app, or wherever you get your podcast from. Cheers.